Once you're aware of the suffering that's going on in the world, it just brings out something in you that makes you want to address the situation and do what you can to improve it. The thought that people are drowning trying to cross the Mediterranean is just, in this day and age, it just seems ridiculous. It's such a small body of water. It should never be such a huge obstacle. There are so many people moving north, so many people leaving Africa, facing persecution, struggling in their own countries. There are so many reasons that these people need to leave their home environment and to make their way to better places and safer places. And the fact that the most dangerous part of their journey should be crossing the Mediterranean is just absurd. And there's a definite need for safe passage for these people, for safe and legal passage, and that's what MSF is definitely promoting. But in the interim, if there isn't safe and legal passage, what there needs to be is some kind of humanitarian-led rescue system there for those people who are taking unbelievable risks. And people are so genuinely grateful, because it's true, we've saved their lives. If we weren't there, many of those people would drown. It's very important to keep the faces real and not just have people as numbers. And to go down there and you hold somebody's hand and you hear their story for 5 minutes and you share a laugh with them, and going down, especially with the women for me, and sitting in that area with these young, hopeful women and hearing the stories of what they faced in Nigeria, or the horrors that they've faced on the journey to get as far as they have, and just know that for the time that they're on board, they do get some respect and some dignity and some compassion and some clean clothes and some genuine human attention. For me, it felt really like I was doing a humanitarian act, and I'm very proud to be part of it.